As for the Information and Communications Technology Chief, he says his main priority is to improve internet connectivity in the Philippines. Ivan Uy notes he plans to continue the agency's free Wi-Fi project. But he admits there are issues that need to be addressed.
Ang iba po kasi dyan, ang issue is hardware, ang iba issue is connectivity, ang iba issue is the contractor, ang iba issue is non-payment of the subscription, ang iba naman issue is the local government hindi ready to deploy this. So iba-iba po ang concerns nila at mahirap po magbigay ng schedule dahil we have to address this all individually po.
Meanwhile, Transport Secretary Jaime Bautista discussed plans with transport regulators on how to alleviate the plight of commuters. He also said he will need to study whether to retain or tweak the government's free ride program. President Marcos last week extended the free rides at the EDSA carousel until December. He also approved free train rides for students when classes resume in August. Commission on Audit Chairperson Jose Calida vows to continue the agency's mandate of protecting government funds. Calida was welcomed by key officials of COA Monday morning as he spent his first full day in office. Calida said he was not given any marching orders by President Bongbong Marcos. He also did not categorically answer if he will continue the agency's practice of publishing annual audit reports on government agencies. As former Solicitor General, Calida was the subject of several audit reports by state auditors.
Babantayan talaga namin, di ba? Kasi sa Supreme Court nga lang, panalo na kami palagi. Kaya manalo pa rin kami.
Interior and Local Government Secretary Benhur Abalos Jr. also listing his priorities for his first 100 days in office. These include the efficient implementation of the Mandanas ruling, the fast-tracking of over 2,000 pending local government permits to build telecommunication towers, and jail decongestion. Abalos, who will be heading the police force, also vowed to continue the Duterte administration's bloody war on drugs.
The war against drugs will be as intensive as before on the basis on my oath as a public official in accordance with the Constitution. Of course, we will get rid of the scalawags. No? Kailangan mawala scalawags. Pero kung konting porsyento yan eh. Marami tayong magagaling na police. Marami po yan. Ayaw natin yung maliit na porsyento na ay masira. No? But what is important, itong nakaharap sa drug war, ay mamotivate naman natin. Kawawa naman kung babalikan ng mga malaki sindikato.
The Philippines' Drug Enforcement Agency, meanwhile, says it will focus on running after suppliers and rehabilitating users in communities.
I believe we have already the strategy in place under the Philippine Anti-Drug Strategy, which is the supply reduction, demand reduction, focusing more on the rehabilitation and reintegration program. That will complete itong main strategy ng PDEA, which is the barangay drug clearing program.
Malacañang gives its assurance it will not take too long until all cabinet positions are filled. That remark from Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles comes as the palace held its first media briefing under the new administration. Cruz Angeles asserts President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. is carefully reviewing the qualifications of candidates. Marcos has yet to name the heads of several government agencies, including the Departments of Health, Energy, and Environment.
Wala po sa binibigay sa amin na sinasabi nilang deadline. Ang sinasabi is masuri talaga ang pag-evaluate nila dito sa mga kandidato para sa mga posisyon. I understand that this is now going through the final evaluation stage. So, I don't think it will take too long. Ang sinasabi lang namin is dumadaan sa matinding pagsusuri. Wala tayong sinasabi nahihirapan or anything like that. But because these are important, precisely because these are very important positions, kailangan dumaan talaga sa butas ng karayom. We will rely on the president's wisdom to choose the best people for the job.